those Republican leaders and President Trump don't give a about the people they were trying to hurt. They call it a skinny budget. I call it a budget.
He's a damn liar. That's what I say, pal. You're right, he's a liar. Because the Republican leadership doesn't give a about people who are suffering. That's bull, friends. They call it a skinny budget. I call it a budget.
Just another one for good measure there for you. That was the newly elected chair of the DNC, Tom Perez, using some pretty salty language, we'll just say. We all know President Trump is no stranger to swearing himself, but what is Tom Perez doing here? With me now, Joe Borelli is here, Republican councilman for New York City. Of course, Keith Boykin is CNN political commentator and a former aide in the Clinton White House, and David Drucker is a CNN political analyst and senior congressional correspondent for the Washington Examiner. Keith, so you've got Tom Perez. There's one video that's out there we didn't include there where there is a small child standing right behind him when he is using his kind of non-filtered version of his speech. I want to know, what is Tom Perez doing? Because one of the most powerful ads from the election, you will remember, is when Democrats using Donald Trump's own words, children sitting in front of television watching this. Tom Perez is using very similar language as there in one of these videos I saw, a kid is standing right behind him. Is this the strategy to counter Donald Trump now?
I don't think that what Tom Perez is doing is a part of the strategy. I think he's really speaking out of his own passion. I've never met Tom Perez. I've never spoken to him about this. I don't know what the Democratic Party is doing with this. But I think there's a lot of people who are really angry out there. And, you know, President Obama, he's giving a speech today and everything. I understand that. But he and Michelle Obama took the high road. You know, when they go low, we go high.
And so the rest of the party doesn't
necessarily feel that way. The rest of the party is upset. They're angry. And they're angry because Trump, who was perhaps the most vulgar presidential, not candidate, but president we've had since going back to the Lyndon Johnson and Richard Nixon era, he is just just a whole new figure. So people don't really know how to respond to him. He can get away with anything. He can stand in front of on Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody, like he said, and supporters won't abandon him. So the Democrats feel like they're caught.
You get down in the muck with him now, apparently.
What else can you do?
Do Democrats have a strategy at this point that you've noticed in this post-election period of time, how to counter Donald Trump?
No. I think they have...
I'm not going to say anything else.
Well, look, I think this is a question that I've been asking, and I think what you've seen are a lot of Democrats with thoughtful strategies and ideas that they've implemented in attempting to counter President Trump. And I think you've seen this from activists and from lawmakers and from Democratic and progressive thinkers. I think what you haven't seen yet is an overarching message that everybody kind of gets behind that is simple and easy to digest and is a way for the party to appeal beyond its tent so that it can grow the number of elected officials it has both at the local level and the federal level. And I think that for Democrats is the key. Which is, I understand, and it's right for the chairman to try and harness all of this passion. And it's real. I mean,
yeah,
I'm not
trying to downplay that. But
there's a way to do it because you don't want to appeal to the base. You already have the base. You want to appeal to people that tend to vote Republican or voted for President Trump this time around, aren't sure if they're comfortable with him, and you want them to feel comfortable in the Democratic Party. And you don't do that by accusing Republicans of purposely trying to hurt people. You could do that by saying Republican policies are hurting you. But when Chairman Perez, forget the expletive, says they're trying to hurt you, a lot of people that vote Republican are going to hear, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I've been voting Republican for years. We're not trying to hurt anybody.
That's not turning people on, it's hurting more people. Let's talk about ratings, Joe. I know you